Hey Noah, why do you think you're gonna be the next Mr. NHS?
Because I'd flip out if I won.
So Noah, tell us something interesting about yourself.
I can partially do anything. I can partially do a flip throw, partially spin a basketball, partially do tennis, but I can win this entire thing.
Hey, Matt.
Hey, I didn't see you there.
Matt, why do you think you're gonna be the next Mr. NHS?
Well, first off, those of you who think you know me don't really know me. I'm very silent but deadly, kind-hearted yet ruthless. I'm very shy but courageous. And also, I'm the perfect mix of Irish and Italian. My baby blue eyes and my bright smile will win me this year's title of Mr. NHS.
Hey, Matt, so tell us something interesting about yourself.
Well, you know, I kind of have 9 varsity letters. Yes, you heard that right, ladies and gentlemen. I have 9 varsity letters. You know, I'm kind of a big deal. Now watch this.
Hey, Ryan.
What's up?
Why do you think you're going to be the next Mr. NHS?
I'm going to be the next Mr. NHS as the basketball team went 3-16 this year. I deserve to win something.
Tell us something interesting about yourself.
Something interesting about me is that I don't miss.
Hey Connor, why do you think you're gonna be the next Mr. NHS?
Because I'm the best.
So tell us something interesting about yourself.
I could open a water ball with one hand. Crossbar.
Why do you think you'll be the next Mr. NHS?
I mean, it's either Prom King or Mr. NHS, so one or the other.
Tell me something interesting about yourself.
Well, Ashley, my parents will let me have a dog of my own, so I go to other people's houses and pet their own dogs because I love dogs.
Yeah.
Hey Chris, why do you think you're gonna be the next Mr. NHS?
I'm the total package, you know. I got the looks, the hair, and the comedy.
Wait, Chris, tell us something interesting about yourself.
I used to wet the bed till I was 12.
So Jeff, why do you think you're gonna be the next Mr. NHS?
Can I get a quick round of applause from the audience, please? More. More. I want more. I'm not satisfied. I want more. Clap! Thank you. Okay, now you can all stop. I want to be Mr. NHS. Mostly because I love entertaining crowds. I always love having fun, and I always love trying to make people laugh. So I hope you guys laugh a little. I hope you enjoy the show. And I have kind of a big surprise for you guys.
So, Jeff, why don't you tell us something interesting about yourself?
Oh, interesting. Let me just go out and check my phone because I have that now. I didn't have that for a while, so. Oh, and here's another interesting. I have keys now. Yeah, baby, I can drive my 1989 Volvo. Ladies, wherever you want to go. Anne-Marie. Look, I can also do something else that's pretty dope. Watch this.
Hello, this is Donald Trump. Mr. NHS is gonna be huge, okay? It's gonna be fantastic. I'm there, I'm gonna be fantastic. Everybody else, they're gonna be terrible. The whole show, though, it's gonna be great. You're gonna love it, it's gonna be fantastic. And if I don't win, it's gonna be rigged, okay? I already promised you that. It's gonna be rigged. I can guarantee you, totally rigged if I don't win. Thank you.
Hey Josh, why do you think you're going to be the next Mr. NHS?
Well, I have a beard, and people with beards are just naturally successful at everything. So,
Josh,
can't you see I'm doing something here?
Sorry, I have an important question.
Go ahead.
Tell us something interesting about yourself.
Well, when I was 6 years old, I went grocery shopping with my parents and I left with a different family and lived with them for an entire week.
Why do you think you're going to be the next Mr. NHS?
Firstly, I feel I'm going to be the next Mr. NHS simply because I want to prove that short people can make a difference in the world.
Tell me something interesting about yourself.
Something interesting about myself? Well, I'm the only person on this planet that has ever survived solely off of pizza and chicken nuggets.
Good morning, Northbridge. Good morning, Northbridge. Good morning, Northbridge.
All right, Joe.
Oh, hey.
Why do you think you're going to be the next Mr. NHS?
I'm going to be the next Mr. NHS because I'm not your average Joe.
Tell me something interesting about yourself.
Well, something interesting about myself. In school, when teachers have a question, they ask me to stay after for extra help and help them.
So why do you have a bird on your shoulder?
Well, he's my wingman.
Hey guys, what are you doing? It's 7:15, Mr. NHS is starting. You're late.
Whoa! I got it!
Favorite thing to do is go to the tennis courts. Joseph can spend hours just laying on the court, staring at the clouds, trying to imagine how cool it would be to be actually good at tennis. He also is just counting down the days until he gets his phone taken away again for the 34th time this month. Sometimes, when staring at the sky, Joseph can see the clouds turn into different shapes, mostly meaning stella octangulars, ray loop polygons, truncated icosahedrons, and rhombic and icosahedrons. Did I forget to mention he also likes math? He hopes one day he can find a girl who enjoys his tennis headbands and tennis fashion as much as him, while also being fascinated by his gorgeous mind. Thank you, Joe. Zach is known for his unique style and exquisite taste. His motto is dress for success. He also has remarkable organizational skills. For Christmas, he asked for a label maker. He also has excellent hygiene. If you are looking for Zach, he is most likely at a school event. He practically lives at NHS, as he is a part of almost every club. His constant participation in activities leave him a little on edge, as he is always in a constant state of stress. He has about 9 anxiety attacks a day. He gets so nervous that his hands profusely sweat. Everyone thinks it's gross, but he considers it a superpower. They call him Clam Boy. Thank you, Zach. When Matt isn't tearing up LaSalle Field playing lacrosse and football, he is quite busy volunteering at St. Patrick's Church. When he isn't at school and volunteering, you can find him working one of his 3 jobs. On Monday, Wednesday, Saturday, and Sunday nights, you can find Matt working at Dunkin' Donuts in Upton. On Saturday mornings, he works at Shrewsbury Parks and Rec, coaching basketball with his old football coach, Mr. McEwen. The funny thing is, Matt has never played basketball before, and he's quite bad at it. On the days when he isn't working at Dunkin' Donuts, you can find him shredding gnar at Ski Ward in Shrewsbury, teaching the little kids how to carve up the slopes. And when he isn't doing that, he's a volunteer coach for his brother's Special Olympics ski team. When Matt has some free time on his hands, you can find him passed out in his bed or in his classes. And if you're lucky, you can even find him studying for tests and quizzes. Thank you, Matt.
Noah enjoys reliving his actual high school glory days. By dressing with his white shirt, flannel, and jeans, he accurately portrays the sexy Phil from Acts of Murder. His hobbies include, but are not limited to, being bored, and video games. However, his friends know that his true hobby and lifelong passion is eating. With a metabolism faster than he can run, Noah is known for eating anytime, anywhere, and annoying anyone around him by not gaining any weight. Thank you, Noah.
When Josh isn't devoting hours of community service at the local nursing homes, gardens, or reading books to the homeless, you can find him driving around town in his trusty steed, Nancy the Nissan. A usual week for Josh involves shooting a few hoops, hitting a few dingers on the baseball field, imitating youngsters at the skate park, and of course, teeing off at his favorite golf club, Waynesville Golf Course. Josh enjoys listening to rap a lot, especially Tupac, which is his all-time favorite. Josh is completely devoted to his schoolwork, taking on 14 APs, teaching a geothermal nuclear engineering course, and reading a book every day. Over the summer, you can find Josh mowing greens at the golf course and posting a Snapchat story at 4:30 in the morning every day, just so everybody knows he's awake that early in the summer. Thank you, Josh.
When Chris isn't napping or eating with his friends at Buffalo Wild Wings, Chris likes to consider himself a below-mediocre golfer in which he spends half the time he plays looking for his ball in the woods. And after a long day of golfing, he likes to sit back and relax and watch his favorite team, the Red Sox. During the winter, good luck trying to get a hold of him because he locks himself in his room and hibernates and only comes out to talk to people around the holidays. After that, he goes back to his room until spring comes again. When he wants to sit back and relax, he loves to listen to his favorite music and attempt to play it, although he lacks any musical talent. When he is done listening to music, he watches his favorite movies that include Step Brothers and Anchorman. After any of these movies, he's usually asleep at a late 10 p.m. Thank you, Chris. When Donald isn't wandering around the White House looking for things to make great again, he's wandering around the world looking for things to make great again. He has very expensive tastes and is almost like a child wanting only what other people have, like the presidency. He's always seen wearing his power suit because it's a power move. He enjoys drawing on all of Hillary Clinton's official portraits during his mandatory half-hour doodle time, almost as much as he enjoys prank calling Ted Cruz about bragging about winning the presidential election, even though he didn't even want to. When he gets cranky, he has to have nap time, but he makes sure to bring his official American flag sippy cup to bed with him. In order to fall asleep, he has Ben Carson read literally anything to him. Once he wakes up, it's snack time, which usually consists of a super-sized french fry, a triple bacon cheeseburger, and a Diet Coke. He's currently working on a children's book for himself, composed entirely of his own funny tweets and the funniest things he's ever said. Finally, he's working on figuring out how to ban shredded cheese so we can make America great again. Thank you, President Trump. When Connor's not running for president or working on his mixtape, you can catch Connor spending his time and his money at Wendy's. Every weekend, Connor gets a text from someone asking if he'd like to go to Wendy's, and every time he says yes. He has been to Wendy's a total of 16 times just this year. When he's rarely not at Wendy's, Connor enjoys a good book, but only ones with lots of pictures. When the weather is nice, Connor enjoys heading up to the soccer fields to kick the ball around with some friends. And every once in a while, the ball actually goes in the back of the net. Thank you, Connor. Tall, smart, and awkward are just a few words that can be thrown around to describe Ryan Brochu. With his typical khaki and button-up look, Ryan is trying to dress the part of a teacher as he prepares for his life down the road. You can normally find him at his house. He isn't invited to go many places, but he makes the most of his time. When he is out, you can find him either at the basketball court or baseball field, if not driving Connor Nolan around the entire Worcester County since he can't drive yet. Ryan is a good friend and has a laid-back personality when he is not stressing and planning basically every aspect of his life. Going to Stonehill next year to further his education, he hopes to win this competition and return back to Northbridge, not only working beside the great Miss Heaney, but also as a former Mr. NHS winner as well. Thank you, Ryan. Mark LeBlanc is hands down one of the coolest people you will ever meet in your entire life. For those blessed enough to be in his presence, they say that by simply standing near him, it is as if they can feel the awesomeness radiating from him. You may be asking yourself, what makes Mark such an absolute stud? Well, where do we even begin? A good place to start is to talk about Mark's passion for drinking water. He drinks a whole entire bottle of water every single day and is able to keep himself hydrated on a regular basis. If that doesn't just say cool, I really don't know what does. Another fact about Mark that sets him apart from everyone else is that he is great at sleeping. Mark can go to sleep every single night for a time period that varies between 6 and 10 hours. What makes this so impressive is that his bed isn't even that comfortable, and he only needs 3 stuffed animals to keep him safe from the monsters in his closet. Perhaps Mark's strongest quality is his ability to drive. Mark is able to drive to his destination in a very safe manner, making sure to follow all speed limits. He has only ever crashed his car once, but as we all know, it was the guardrail's fault. Thank you, Mark. Great, and that concludes the casual wear category. Next up is the swimwear portion of the show. The boys will be putting their beach bodies to the test and tell us all about their passion for summertime and the beach. Joe doesn't go to the beach often, but when he does, he likes to stand out. are everywhere. These guys are the standard of male beauty. While of course Joseph has the chiseled abs, the bulging muscles, and the luxurious hair, he would rather not show them off at the beach. He has made it his life's mission to prove that male beauty comes in all forms. Yes, believe it or not, he even believes guys in marching band uniforms can be just as beautiful as any other. He wears this to the beach to bring attention to his cause. Plus, the feather in that hat is a real lady killer. So it is a win-win, win-win scenario when he wears this to the beach. Thank you, Joe. Zach isn't the most experienced swimmer. He needs his mom's assistance. Floats complete Zach's signature look. As his mother says, you can never be too safe. Zach only likes to swim in blow-up pools where he is most comfortable. He doesn't enjoy swimming in big bodies of water because he fears multiple things. He is afraid of sharks, jellyfish, stingrays, hermit crabs, hot sand, seaweed, flip-flops, styrofoam, blenders, mailboxes, lemons, Yahtzee, weathermen, the state of Wyoming, Nicolas Cage, anything the color orange, and commitment. Good thing he has his mother to protect him from anything, especially sunburns. So if you see Zach at the beach, remember to keep your distance because he is more scared of you than you are of him. Thank you, Zach and his mom. Although Matt's diet is one of a three-year-old's, he is a pretty jacked dude. His six-pack and his lean but muscular figure is strategically built from a serious diet of chicken nuggets and french fries. Due to his busy work schedule, he does not have enough time to hit the gym. But look at him. He doesn't need to. He's shredded. He could be the next Calvin Klein model with those baby blue eyes and that bright smile. He'd knock them dead. Thank you, Matt. During the summer, Noah enjoys taking a long, nice stroll to the closest beach and sitting in his industrial freezer. He enjoys watching everyone through the window as they slowly burn their skin. He may be the only one not burning calories, but he'll be the only one not burning in the sun. Thank you, Noah. When Josh does have time to take off from mowing greens over the summer, you can find him at his uncle's lake house in New Hampshire. Josh will never take his shirt off though, for his muscles would be too glorious for the innocent families living around the lake. Josh will always wear Sperry's too and never take them off. Nobody likes feet. When Josh owns a bathing suit, he makes sure it's the smallest possible one to wear. Not too small though, just right. Josh has a pair of sunglasses for every day of the week, which he has to wear because he shines so brightly. Josh has never worn sunscreen in his entire life. Legend has it, it's because his muscles are what protects him from the sunlight, just not his eyes. Thank you, Josh. Due to Chris's pale skin, he really doesn't like to go swimming at the beach. So when you see him there, he is always wearing this fashionable attire. And in those rare moments when he does decide to swim, people run and hide from him because they think he is a ghost. But he only has a 1 hour time limit to stay out in the sun because he becomes a lobster and can't walk. He usually lathers himself in a ton of sunscreen, which doesn't help, so he chooses to skip the swimming part and fish instead. He wears this extremely fashionable attire, so no amount of sun will hit his body, and he won't get any deadly burns. No worries though, while Chris wears this, he still chooses to be extremely stylish, and he likes to consider himself a trendsetter. He hates going in the water for one big reason. He has a fear of any sea creature eating his feet. Thank you, Chris. Modeling his favorite swimsuit, which is actually just his favorite suit. Donald doesn't go swimming because deserve to touch him. After he gets sand in his shoes, he forces the lifeguards to rescue him just so he can get some of their delicious lifesaver candy. He hasn't gone swimming since the summer of 55 when he had a terrible experience involving an octopus, a Chevrolet, his hair, and a pirate's wooden leg, all happening aboard a life-size replica of Captain Blackbeard's ship. He goes to the beach now only to wave at the waves and to pretend like he's a part of the Coast Guard. He has just recently filed a new executive action to outlaw all incoming seaweed and classify it as a banned substance. Thank you, President Trump. Connor likes to wear slimmer fitting clothes and is a big fan of Hawaiian shirts. Connor loves the beach. He loves kicking back and relaxing and listening to some smooth tropical music. Connor is most relaxed when he's at the beach. He's so relaxed that his heart rate often reaches a peak low of 95. Connor only likes the beach for tanning as he can't even swim. Oh well. Thank you, Connor. For his swimwear, Ryan Brochu has chosen more of a conservative look tonight. As he races across the stage in his designer grass skirt, flowing every which way, matched up with his exquisite coconut top, Ryan likes to get in the tropical vibe all year round. Looking to get an even tan, but look fashionable while doing so, Ryan's swimwear does the perfect job. While he walks around on his local beach in the great state of Rhode Island or enjoys a great game of beach volleyball, Ryan can be spotted also with his webbed water shoes to ensure no cuts on his feet. They also provide more traction when running into the water to enjoy a nice afternoon swim. Bold? You bet it is. Fashionable? You can be the judge of that. Rest be assured, he is definitely an interesting sight every time he steps onto the sand. Thank you, Ryan. As you can see, Mark has yet again gone against the grain to set himself apart from everyone else to prove just how awesome he is with his unique choice of swimwear. Mark not only is wearing a bathing suit, but is also wearing a plain white t-shirt and some flip-flops. Top it all off with a baseball cap and some sunglasses, and you have an outfit that just screams intricate and unique. I mean, who wouldn't think to wear a bathing suit in a swimwear category? I sure wouldn't. This is just more proof that Mark is such a groundbreaking human being with the way that he goes about his life, setting the bar for everyone else to attempt to reach it. But as we all know, they never actually will. His outfit is so groundbreaking that he can even go swimming in it. Whether it be a pool, lake, or ocean, this complex outfit will allow for any sort of aquatic submergence, which is truly an amazing feat to accomplish. Thank you, Mark. At this time, we have a very special question for a specific member of the audience. So, Marissa Burt, could you please stand up?
Chill. I know this is Mr. NHS, but every Mr. needs his missus, so. I know that sounded like a proposal, but it wasn't. Just so you know, it is a proposal.
All right. Up next, we have the mystery category. Keep in mind the boys have no idea what's about to come and have not been able to prepare for this round. Could the boys please come to the stage now?
Just
dying to know what this is, so they're finally gonna get to find out. So this year's mystery category is a spelling bee. So underneath each of your chairs is a whiteboard and a marker. We're gonna give you a word to spell, so grab your whiteboards and your markers. You're gonna wanna stay standing, because if you're sitting, that means you're out. So stay standing. All right, so we're gonna give you 15 seconds, and when your time is up, turn around your whiteboard, try like not to let anyone around see the way you spell. So we're gonna ding when your time's up. And if you, no, that's not the word. If you get it right, you're gonna stay standing, and if you get it wrong, you're gonna sit. The last person standing wins, and if all the remaining contestants spell the word wrong, a new word will be given until someone spells it right. Are you guys ready?
Yes.
All right, here we go. Okay, first word, dog. A domesticated carnivorous mammal that typically has a long snout, an acute sense of smell, and a barking, howling, or whining voice. The definition is a building for human habitation. Good job, that was a good round. Next word, meat. The flesh of animals as used for food. Next word, friend. A person whom one knows and shares mutual affection. Next word, weight. The amount or quantity of heaviness or mass. Next word, library. A building or room containing a collection of books. I'm sorry, Chris, your time is up. Next word, surprise. To strike or occur to you with a sudden feeling of wonder or astonishment. Sorry, Mark, you're out. Mark, it's S-U-R-P-R-I. Next word, tomorrow, the day after today. Mr. Trump, I'm sorry, but you are out. I'm sorry, Connor, there are no two M's in tomorrow. Next word, vegetable. Any plant whose fruit, seeds, roots, stems, leaves, or flower parts are used as food. Next word, attendance.
the action or state of going regularly to or being present at a place or event. Next word, weird, involving or suggesting the supernatural. Next word, schedule, a plan for carrying out a process or procedure. Next word, calendar, a table or register with the days of each month and week in a year. Final spellings? Zach, you're out. It's AR. Next word, vacuum, an object used for cleaning. Already noticed, we have some pretty talented guys here tonight. In this next section, they will be showing off what they do best. So first up, we have Joe Canoy. Joseph is able to play approximately 13.457 instruments, but one of his favorites is the piano. Some people have claimed that he has the ability to convey any emotion through the piano. The notes he plays on the piano have been set to paint a vivid picture. Tonight, we're gonna pick some emotions out of a hat randomly. And Joe will come up with something on the spot to convey that emotion. Let's welcome him to the stage as he tickles the ivory. First up, could you please play Happy?
Sure can.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Can you do one more? Can you please do sad? Next up, we have Zachary Marion. Zach has the ideal body. He is 46 pounds of pure steel. His nutrition consists of nails, raw eggs, and linguine. He tends to show off in front of the ladies. If you are looking for Zach, go to the local gym or zoo. He likes to wrestle the gorillas. His workouts consist of a mean, long, exaggerated stretch. His body is a temple and he cannot afford any strenuous pain. Just look at those calves. He likes to start out heavy to get the juices flowing. His favorite workout is curling. Zach's enormous biceps were not made overnight, clearly. His arms look as if someone just pumped them with beef and chiseled them with stone. Some people mistake him for Rob Gronkowski. He likes to mix up his workout routine and do anything that seems right to him. He tries to work out every muscle in his body. He's so strong, he can flex his eyebrows. Watch as he attempts to reach his personal best with his heaviest clean and jerk yet. And agility on and off LaSalle Field, I bet you were unaware of their fabulous ability to shake what their mamas gave them. Now, here they are to showcase their talents.
Good
guys. Next up, we have Josh Keaton. Josh has many talents, and for him to choose just one was way too tough. So here we have Mr. Warzeka and Josh to show off some nifty handshakes.
Chris.
gentlemen, please welcome the President of the United States, Donald J. Trump, for an important press conference.
So I actually had the exact same town as Christopher Coyle. He stole it. Him and Hillary, they did it. I'm gonna react with a better one. I'm gonna do a Q&A with questions from the crowd. But if I have not paid you to ask me questions, do not ask them. Let's begin. Yes, you.
I was wondering, how do you feel about the new cell phone policy in the school?
Excuse me, I was talking. The new cell phone policy is fantastic. I love it. It stops people from tweeting horrible lies about me. And the Wi-Fi. I replaced Obama's Wi-Fi with a better, more improved Wi-Fi. I made Wi-Fi great again. Next question. Yes, you, Baldy. Today. Wrong, I would never poke fun at another member of the NHS community, okay? But if I did poke fun at Mark LeBlanc, there'd be a lot of subject matter to choose from. I could talk about how he's so short. I could talk about his small ears. I could talk about his gross beard. I could talk about how he always eats fast food. And I could talk about how he's allergic to peanut butter. And I could talk about how he crashed into a guardrail. But I'm not gonna say any of those things. Because I'm cooperating, I'm following the rules, I'm not making fun of anybody on this stage at all. Next question.
Well, if you feel that strongly about him, how do you feel about the other contestants?
See, the thing with the other contestants is, as soon as I heard who they were, I immediately finished my triple bacon cheeseburger, my supersized fry, and my Diet Coke, because I'm American, and that's what I do. I immediately then went to sit on my toilet bowl and tweet about all of them, but I never posted any tweets about any of them. Because I wanted you guys to hear these first. At Josh Keaton. Josh, I hope you do better tonight than your golf game, your rap career, or eighth grade lip sync. Be quiet, I'm talking. There's nowhere to go but up from here, Josh. At Zach Marion. If Zach Marion wins Mr. NHS, I would want to shake his hand, but I can't because it's so wet and clammy. Hashtag clammy hands. At Christopher Coyle, it's nice to see that Chris Coyle had finally found a stage big enough for his huge head. It really is huge. He looks like the evil bird from the movie Rio. And if you don't know what that bird looks like, he looks like a peacock, okay? He looks like a peacock. At Devin Gatto. Devin, are you allowed to be here with all these bright lights? Because I think you've had way more concussions than Hillary has sent illegal emails. I'll give you a hint, it's 33,000, okay? 33,000, thank you. At Matt DeLuca, AKA Mad Dog. Mad Dog, I hope you don't run out of gas tonight like how you always do with your car. But if you do, I hope you don't turn into one sad dog. At Joe Canoy. Joe, I have no idea what you're doing here. You know the winner of Mr. NHS doesn't get AP credits, right? You know that? At Abby LeBrie. Abby, I'm not gonna roast you because your father's a cop and cops love me. But if I did, it would be so bad and so horrible, he would have to lock me up for 36 hours. Happy that you got here without crashing into anything, honestly. At Maddie Green, this is... Okay. At Maddie Green, Connor, I thought when you said you were bringing a member of the Green family who is a smart blonde, I thought you were bringing her golden retriever. I didn't think you were bringing Maddie.
this is at Connor Nolan. People keep saying I'm the worst president ever, but did you know that Connor Nolan wants to run for president? I'm just saying it could get worse. Connor has been bragging about his new mixtape, which he plans on dropping, and I'm quite frankly sick of hearing about things that he's never going to do, ever, okay? He's never going to drop that mixtape. And finally, but certainly not least in my book, at Mark LeBlanc. Mark, I took a Twitter poll last Wednesday. It turns out nobody likes you or your Twitter polls, okay? That is all I have to say about those people. Next question. Yes, you in the pants.
Yeah, we heard that Jeff Riker had to drop out tonight. Do you know anything about that?
I heard nothing but fantastic things about Jeffrey. He seems like a really great guy. I don't know him personally, just like I don't know Vladimir Putin, but I both think that they're both fantastic people, okay? Next question. Yes, you in the shirt.
What would you do about all the students who are trying to sneak in the side entrance of school in the morning?
Oh. Easy. I would build a wall. And I would make the students pay for it. That's all I have to say about that. Next question. Yes.
What did you do to prepare for tonight's competition?
We all went through extensive hours of preparation, training with the Navy SEALs and the Navy Sea Lions. I feel like it comes down to primal instincts. My great-great-grandfather was a lion. He had amazing hair. He was king of the jungle, just like how I am king of America and also have fabulous hair. But really, I want you all to give me an enormous round of hands, enormous hands of applause from all of... I've just been given a memo. Can whoever crashed their car into the guardrail outside, Mark LeBlanc, please move out. Thank you, God bless America.
Thank you, Mr. Trump. Under the rap name Skim Milk, Connor has been hyping up his mixtape, Trap Skim. Tonight, we present the world premiere of Skim Milk, performing his debut single, Where It All Began.
How are you doing, y'all? Cover art just dropped. Check it out, at Official Skim on Twitter. That's Hathaway. Biggest of Sumia, it's on the way. I did not care that I'm 3 years late. It's time for me to set the record straight. Cause it's game season, so hope y'all done sleeping. Hope y'all done leaving. But doing all me is time for y'all to get no reason. It all started in like 10th grade when Skim Milk became a rap name. And I told fams that tape come and they didn't get that. I was just fun. A real tip, this was what I said, chill fam, give me till it's live. Told them to give this a try, but I didn't know this to take the time. Started to make my own beats. I found real quick there wasn't foamy. So I started searching the web for fine pre-made beats instead. Download like 20 of them. They kept texting me like mixed up when I said real soon hadn't started. Kinda hope they forgot it. July came, it still wasn't done. I spent the whole summer trying to have fun. Junior year, rolled around. My mixtape could not be found. Whole crew was mad at me. I wouldn't drop a tape that wasn't he. With school and all, I got busy. Had folks in my studies. Couldn't work on something. January came, I still had nothing. Instead, I gave them the name, and then nothing was the same. Called the mixtape Trap Skim. Still ain't started rapping. I said I stopped slacking, but then something strange happened. Hey, all my day ones have had to wait. Making it so soon, yeah, it's on the way. I do not care that I'm 3 years late. It's time for me to set the record straight. It's game season, so hope y'all done sleeping. And hope y'all done leaving. Do it on me, it's time for y'all here without reason. Made it so one night like Yachty. Bossing up like John Gotti. My old friends always got me. Ain't nobody gonna stop me. You are just a carbon copy. But you got nothing on me. You will never be above me. And I don't feel sorry. Long story short, I wasted my time. I just came around with back on track. Back to make my own beats. And the main one I found straight. Hyped it up to all my friends. They took a ride in his mom's Benz.
pass me the encore, and they all seem to be encore. They told me that they loved it, this is the first time I had done it. So I told them 1025, that's when the cover art be dropped. Yeah, I came through, did a lot, they got hyped, I don't know why. It was just a couple screenshots, I too cried for it to fly. So I went back to the music, now I knew that I could do it. Now I knew what I was doing, but I'd been with, I was ruined. Then one night on New Year's Eve, something weird came over me, and I canceled the whole thing. Guess I had a mood swing. In 2 weeks, I changed my mind, started using beats that I designed. Still like 3 years behind, so it's anxious, the perfect time. Show y'all I ain't frontin', and that skill built up for something. Yeah, my mixtape is still coming. This is the intro track, you bump. Hey, all my day ones have had to wait. Been here so soon, yeah, it's all the way. I do not care that 3 years late. It's time for me to set the record straight. It's skim season, so I hope y'all done sleeping, and I hope y'all done leaving. Do it on lean, it's time for y'all to hear the reason. Trap skim is coming so soon. Might even drop the tape in June. I swear I'm never gonna lose. This your new favorite tune. I've taken L since like August. I'm not cocky, I'm just honest. God's real, I'm living proof. I'm the greatest, that's just the truth. Hey, hey, hey. Hey, hold up, hold up, cut the beat. Listen up, hey, listen up. This song drops tonight at 10:25 on my SoundCloud. SoundCloud.com/Trapskim. Full mixtape soon, full single.
Next up, we have Ryan Groshue. Ryan is not typically known as a very talented person, but here he is showing off a side of him that you have never seen before. Please welcome to the stage, performing a professional ribbon dance routine, Mr. Ryan Groshue. Voices of our generation and all generations that came before us. It is my honor to introduce, for one night only, the beyond talented Mark LeBlanc.
Alrighty, let's sing a little song tonight. Don't be afraid to sing along. I know you'll want to. I got sunshine on a cloudy day. When it's cold outside, I got the month of May. Well, I guess you'd say, what can make me feel this way? My girl,
my girl,
my girl, talking about my girl.
My girl.
I've got so much honey, the bees and me. I've got a sweeter song than the birds in the trees. Well, I guess you'd say, what can make me feel this way? My girl,
my girl,
talking about my girl.
For this next section, formal wear, could the lovely ladies in the front row please go meet up with their men and escort them in?
Joseph's perfect date, believe it or not, actually starts 3 weeks before the date. He spends weeks doing the trash and the dishwasher and doing everyone's laundry and cooking dinner every night for his parents so that when he begs them, and yes, I mean beg, like on his knees begging his parents to let him go on a date, they will be in a good mood and say yes. If he miraculously gets their permission, he will jump in his dad's pickup truck, play some smooth jazz music, and head to the lucky girl's house. On the way there, he will stop by a field and pick some beautiful flowers for his beautiful date. When he picks her up, he will greet her with a hearty and church-appropriate side hug, leaving ample room for the Holy Spirit. Then, he will take her to a fancy restaurant. When walking to the door, he will gently adorn her shoulders with his jacket to ensure that she is warm. When they finally get seated, Joe will happen to look at his watch and see that it is already 7:15 p.m. only 15 minutes until his generous 7:30 curfew. He will then rush out of the restaurant and hurry back to her house. When they arrive back home, his lovely date will begin to depart. Before she leaves the truck, he will stop her and slowly lean in for a goodbye kiss. Just before their lips meet in the starlit evening, he will glance up and see his mother in the rearview mirror and realizes that she has been following them the whole time, thus concluding his perfect night. And oh, be assured that there was no kiss that evening. Okay, Joe, for your first question.
Thank you.
If you found a four-leaf clover, what would you wish for and why?
Four-leaf clover. It just so happens that today is St. Patrick's Day. Yeah. And the clover is actually Irish.
Yeah. So what would you wish for?
So if I were able to wish for anything, the wish I would wish for would be my wish, and my one and only wish, that I would wish upon a star makes no difference in who you are. But just kidding. My wish would be that in second grade, I had learned how to spell vegetable. V-E-G-E-T. Able. So I would wish for that.
Thanks, Joe. Next question. If you were the principal of Northbridge High School, what rule would you change and why?
Wow. I mean, wow, that's like, I think rules aren't placed to guarantee a certain level of security and safety. Thus being said, the rule that I would reverse or change is I would make the morning announcements from 7:25 to 10:30. So that way, the entire morning, you get to hear me, right? And then, no classes, you hear me, and then, guess what? It's lunchtime. And we all know what lunchtime means. Food.
Yeah. Thanks,
Joe. That's all I have to say about that.
Awesome, so that was it, you get two questions.
Oh, hey, thank you very much.
Thank you, great job.
You're welcome.
Thank you, Joe and Jocelyn. Zach likes to be picked up promptly at 4:30, so he can be back for his bedtime at 7:30. Wary he would be late, he would begin getting ready for the date the day before. She would pick him up at the top of his driveway so he wouldn't have to walk. They would then drive to American Eagle, where he would try to sell her rewards cards. Afterwards, they would go to a fast food restaurant because that's all Zach can afford. Retail doesn't pay too well. Later, they would drive home, jamming out to Copacabana. Then he would bring her to his house, where he would offer to give her the hands in Mario Kart. If she wasn't feeling it, they would instead watch The Lion King. At the end of the movie, his date would need to hand him tissues due to his excessive crying. Okay, Zach, for your first question. If you had $1 million, what would be the first thing you would buy and why?
A dog.
Why?
I like dogs a lot.
Okay. All right, this year marks the 150th graduation, for those of you that didn't know that. So what do you think has been the biggest change over the past 150 years?
That is a good question, Ashley. Thank you for giving me that question, because I know what I'm gonna say. Well, I know the high school used to be at the middle school, so that's my answer.
Thanks, Zach. Good one. Yeah. All right, thank you, Zach.
Thank you, girls.
Thank you, Zach and Abby. Matt's perfect date would be to take a day trip to Martha's Vineyard during the summer. The date would start off with Matt picking up his date in his new Jeep. With the top off and the windows rolled down, they would blast Bad and Bougie and bump the whole ride down before getting onto the ferry. They'd rent bikes for the day and ride all over the island, making a few stops here and there to go shopping, because we all know girls love to shop. Their last stop would be the beach, where they would have a romantic dinner and watch the sunset before hopping on the ferry and cruising back home in style. Okay, for your first question, if you could trade places with any other person for a week, famous or not, living or dead, real or fictional, with whom would it be and why?
Tom Brady.
Why? Why?
Because he has 5 Super Bowls and Super Bowl rings, and he's going to be going on for his 6th.
Okay. Awesome. For your second question, if one of NHS's teachers were an animal, what animal would he or she be and why?
That is a really tricky question. I don't know if I'll get in trouble for this. But it would have to be Mr. Lazotte. He would be a goat because He sounds like a goat. Yeah, that's right.
Okay, thank you, Matt. Thank you, Matt and Liana. Noah's perfect date would start with what any great date would start with. An all-you-can-eat buffet for a couple of hours. Then, if the girl is ditched by the end of the meal, he would go out his way to be a gentleman for the rest of the night. He would take her to the movies to watch whichever movie she wanted, regardless of how much of a chick flick it is, as well as buy the movie snacks. Finally, the last activity of the night would end with taking her back to his house for pepperoni bread, hot cocoa, and cuddling by a fire with dozens of blankets wrapped around them, as long as it's summertime, before dropping her off safely at home right after her curfew. If she survives the night and is willing to stay with him, she is guaranteed a ring sometime within the next 3 days. All right, so. Okay, for your first question, if you were a superhero, what would your superpowers be and why?
My superpowers would be to change my superpowers to any superpower I want at any super time.
All right, good answer. Second question.
Uh-oh.
What sport or club do you think should be added to NHS and why?
I am not going to do the Phil answer and say electrical club, but I would have to go with either a dancing club or archery, because let's face it, shooting stuff's fun. With a bow.
All right, thank you. That's all.
I'm in trouble for that one.
Thank you. Thank you, Noah and Casey.
Josh's perfect date would start out with him driving blindfolded to her house and picking his date up in his parents' car. But Josh tells her it's his car, but obviously it isn't, and she knows that too. Upon arrival, Josh keeps the blindfold on until she gets in and then proceeds to start driving. She asks, "Are you sure about this?" And he replies, "Trust me, I'm a professional." Josh will take his date to a local dog kennel to look and play with the dogs. He finds a dog and picks it up and leaves. Nobody asks any questions because it's Josh. Around town, Josh is on the same level as Jay Gatsby, but also the same level as Tom Buchanan. To end off the date, they pick up pizza and he makes her pay for it. They head out to a cliff to look at the stars. They get out so Josh can take a picture of the stars. His date will then take a picture of him because he's also a star. Once he and his date are 30 feet away from his car explodes and he takes a picture of his car with his girl in view and says, "I thought the fire from my car was hot, but you're hotter." They walk away from the car and go in separate directions because Josh has another date with someone different, which starts in about 30 minutes. Okay, Josh. For your first question, what is the last book you read? Describe what the book was about.
I read Beowulf from Miss Travers. I was forced to, but it was very good. Beowulf is the most epic hero of all time. Everybody read that book. I loved it.
Can you give us a few details about the plot?
Yeah, Beowulf dies. You saw it coming, he's an epic hero.
Next question. If you could be one person at Northbridge High School, teacher, administrator, cafeteria worker, janitor, etc., who would you be and why?
Before I answer that, I just want to say happy birthday to my beautiful mother. She's out there somewhere. I don't know where she is, but I love you, Mom. Thank you so much. I love you for everything you do.
What was the question?
If you could be one person at NHS, who would you be and why?
I don't really need your help. I would definitely be Miss Poulin, because she was an amazing math teacher. She taught me so much, and I appreciate her all my heart. I love her.
Okay, thank you, Josh. Thank you, Josh and Olivia. Chris's idea of a perfect date would be picking up whoever is lucky enough to get to spend time with him in one of the many cars, and off they'll go to the most romantic restaurant there is, IKEA. His lucky date would have the honor and privilege of paying for the food because, after all, you are on a date with the Chris Coyle. Yeah! You didn't think it would be free after all, did you? After the romantic meal, he will take you to see a movie, only if he has a gift card. If he doesn't, he will take you to the drive-ins, where you will watch the movie from up the road because he doesn't want to spend money to get in. But be careful, if you say a word during the movie, he will not hesitate to kick you out of the car and make you walk home. If you are still in the car after the movie, he will kindly ask you for some gas money because, after all, it's not free, and you have been in his car for most of the night. After he drops you off at home, he will let you know whether or not you will see him again for another date.
Alright.
What would you rather be, a dog or a cat, and why?
Dogs, I hate cats.
Alright, for your second one, choose an NHS faculty member and give us-
Mr. Dineen.
You should probably wait till you hear the rest of the question.
He likes movies, I like movies.
Can you give us your best impersonation of this person?
Phone in my face. Phone in my face.
Okay, thank you.
That's it?
That's it, thank you. Thank you, Chris and Bailey. Donald's perfect date begins with a morning of spray tearing, followed by longingly staring into his own reflection until the sun slowly begins to set. Since he missed taking a morning hike with his date, he sends his communication and press secretary, Sean Spicer, to apologize to her and offers to take her out on one later that night. Once he arrives to his rescheduled date, he becomes infuriated at the waitstaff's refusal to give him alternative snacks while he waits for his meal. He stomps up and down, and his date starts to leave. So he goes to grab her. Jeff's ideal date begins with him purchasing his lovely lady a huge bouquet of flowers, followed by a slow romantic walk on the beach, gazing off at the sunset until he whisks her away in his 1989 Volvo to a fancy restaurant, Qdoba, where he definitely picks up the bill. He spends the evening complimenting his date on her beauty and sophistication until he politely drives her home and asks her out immediately on a second date. Sarah, you can come pick a number. Okay, Jeffrey, for your first question, if you could only watch one movie for the rest of your life, what would it be and why?
Ferris Bueller's Day Off. Because senior year, all you want to do is skip school, but you can't.
Okay, like second question. What is your favorite cafeteria food and why?
Ooh, they're all so delicious.
but I'm gonna go with enchiladas, okay? Because Sarah loves them. Woo! And I love them because she loves them.
Okay, thank you, Jeffrey. Thank you, Jeffrey and Sarah. Connor's idea of a perfect date begins with his date picking him up because he doesn't have his license yet. And a quick stop at McDonald's where he uses his buy one, get one free coupon to get a sweet deal on some all-day breakfast sandwiches. Afterwards, they drive to Southwick Zoo just so Connor can sing the song Panda to the Pandas. To end the date on a high note, his date drives him to the nearest beach for a nice long walk, followed by Connor writing, "Mixtape soon, follow my SoundCloud," all over the beach. On the drive home, Connor is such a gentleman that he lets his date get the aux cord as long as she plays at least one Kanye West song. Your first question, what famous person do other people tell you that you resemble most?
Kanye West.
Why?
Because we're both the best.
All right. Next, what is your favorite class at NHS and why?
AP Government. I see you. Because Mr. Deneen is a great teacher, and it's a great class. We get a lot of work done, a bunch of hard-working, motivated kids.
Yeah! Okay, thank you. That's all.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Connor and Maddie.
Ryan's perfect date would begin around 5:30 when the stars begin to illuminate the night sky. He would pick his date up, and depending on her preference for the evening, they would indulge in a multitude of delicacies from the Chinese region of the globe. After enjoying their meal over candlelight, the two would adventure out to catch a night game at Fenway Park in Boston. After cheering the Red Sox on to the victory, the two would go into the city to Mike's Pastry Shop to pick out whatever they may want. After enjoying dessert, the two will go out for a walk by the water. Enjoying the company of one another, they would begin their journey home, ending the perfect night. As he pulls up to drop her off, he leaves her with a single rose just to remind her how good of a time he had on his perfect date. Okay, for your first question, if someone wrote a biography about you, what do you think the title should be?
That's a very good question. I'd like to ask you a question. Who the heck would write a biography about me?
Just pretend. Imagine that someone did.
And that's going to be the title. Who the heck wrote a biography about me?
Oh.
Next question. What song best describes one of our administrators and why? And bonus points for singing a line.
Give me a person. I'll think of it on the spot.
Okay, how about Miss Heaney?
Miss Heaney.
Do you need a new person?
No, I'm just trying to think of the perfect song for the perfect lady. We're gonna go with Dancing Queen, because Miss Heaney seems like she likes to go out and have fun on the weekends. Can I?
Could you sing a line?
Dancing Queen, young and sweet, only 17.
Thank you, Ryan and Devin. Would be just as you'd expect, as spectacular as him. That is, if he can ever find a girl to go on a date with. The biggest key to finding Mark's dream girl is that she must have the same passion for breathing that he so possesses. Once he has found his perfect match, Mark will take her out for the night of her life. He will start by picking her up at her house in his very own car, If she takes too long to come outside, he will honk as long as it takes, and he definitely won't open the door for her because ain't nobody got time for that. He will then proceed to take her to the restaurant of his choosing because, of course, his choice is the best choice. It is at the restaurant that he shows her just how much of a gentleman he really is by finishing his entire meal, even his vegetables, and still saving room for dessert. After dinner, Mark shows his date his impressive collection of rocks. Seeing how wonderful Mark really is, she instantly falls in love with him, but explains to her he simply cannot commit to a serious relationship because the only true love in his life is himself.
Let's get to business.
First question, where do you see yourself in 10 years?
Everywhere.
Okay. Alright, second question.
No explanation needed.
Okay. Alright, what teacher do you think is most like you and why?
Mr. Palucha, because we both have the same love for math.
Oh, okay. Thank you. Thank you, Mark and Jess. Some of you. Okay, at this time, we would like to ask all of the boys and their escorts to please return back to the stage. Tonight to have last year's Mr. NHS in the audience with us. We would like to invite Devin Brevelary to the stage to pass along the crown and give a word of advice to the new Mr. NHS.
Okay. So first of all, when I was in that chair, I got asked what my favorite body part was and why. So I'm glad you guys made them appropriate this year. But can we get the spotlight right here, down this corner? So the crown was too big, or my head was too big for the crown, they said. So I passed it up a generation to my dad. And if we could go over a little down that row, my beautiful escort, sorry, Jason. Amelia Wright, thank you. And Miss Heaney, right here, for chartering the jet for me to come here. I've been super busy this whole year, studying at school. So, let's see who won this thing.
Thanks, Devin. Okay, in third place, we have Jeffrey Reichard. Congratulations, Jeffrey. In second place, we have Joe Canoy. And the 2017 Mr. NHS, can we get a drum roll, please?
Devin won, but everyone thought Logan won. So Chris, hats off to you, man. Where are you, Chris?
Can we give a round of applause for him, please? He's a funny kid. So I have a couple of shout outs. So first shout out to my beautiful escort, Abby LaBrie. Round of applause for her, please. And, Mom, are you over there, Mom? Hi, Mom. Shout out, can we give a round of applause for my mom, please? Okay, but most importantly, we have our two amazing MCs, Ashley Sonsky and Megan Ferraro. Huge round of applause for them, please. And finally, the girl who made it all happen, Anne-Marie Haas. Wherever you are, Anne-Marie, where are you at? She, Anne-Marie, killed it with these two girls. They ran the whole entire thing. We call Anne-Marie Mom because she babied us all. We couldn't have done it without you three. Thank you, guys. And also, shout out to my class advisors, Ms. Van Acker and Ms. Heaney. Round of applause for them too, please. So, thank you guys for coming to an awesome show. I'll be back next year.
Let's hear it up again for Zach Marion. And thank you all for coming. That concludes tonight's show. Have a good night, everybody.